Okay, number four. Unrestricted free agent Candace Parker signs with Chicago.
Oh, this is four?
That is number four.
I mean, I have an idea of what the top two are.
I'm thinking. Yeah. I think I know the top two, but like
it was my two, and I had it at one for a minute.
This certainly this was the whole story,
the guiding story
moments in terms of moments and stories and like the Twitter thing that woke you up. It's top two. It's just.
Yeah, I want to include
it. Could be the biggest. It could be the biggest in terms of acquisition of like a player changing from one team to another we've had in league history. I'd have to check my history to rectify that. But
I didn't know how I could like splice this in, but I wanted to include that night on Thursday Night Basketball when Candace was talking to Shaq and Dwayne Wade and Shaq referenced her only having one ring. And she was like, I'm not done winning rings. like very clearly, and like I think at that point she'd already made the decision to go back to Chicago, so like we knew she was talking about getting the Sky one, and it just felt like that happened like well before the season started, but that felt like, oh, it's kind of destined to happen, like she's got her sights set on exactly what we think.
By the way, Candace, I was really close to making Candace cleaning up the NBA on TNT desk like as its own spot.
Candace on NBA and TNT.
I ended up not, but her just showing up and owning. But that's like, I'm glad you called out that moment because it speaks so much to it. But so much went behind that change that it just caused this seismic shift. And it was kind of one of those cases of, we're seeing that there's a few players on our free agent list right now who could make it interesting, maybe not at that same level, but could make a very seismic splash. And we're going to start seeing that trend happen a little more and more year after year. And it speaks to the fact of like media types, whether it's us, whether it's mainstream, like free agency is starting to become an event for WNBA fans. And if you haven't noticed, that's a huge growth sign. It's a huge sign that it's in a direction you want it to go when those types of discussions are happening. And so that moment was felt so hard that I am honestly shocked it's at four. I'm curious. I have a strong feeling what three are, the top three are. And I'm super duper excited for one of them. but I just, in terms of that type of story, that free agency transition type of scenario, it was big. And I mean, it kind of tells almost the whole story, at least for the WNBA season. So much of what we experienced during that season, we can come back to that moment as like a weird powder keg.
No. And for me, like that moment has two levels, and the audio clip that podcast listeners just heard kind of covers her talking about it on NBA on TNT and what it meant to her and her family for her to be going back home and her grandma being so excited because she'd be around to see her play basketball. Like all those things were super impactful on a personal level, but like each of us for years have been talking about how Chicago's so close. And in that moment, when that news came out, everyone just sort of felt like this is the time. And it was like, it didn't seem like it the first part of the season, but in that moment when we found out of it, oh, Chicago's going to do this. And then they did it. And it was obviously so great, but you know, it was big in both ways, where it felt like a great personal moment for her, but it also felt like a great moment for the Chicago franchise and realizing like, oh, this is the year they put it together. And we all had that kind of feeling all the way back in, what was it, Barry, when that news broke? Like, yeah,